Stay tuned.
Stay, good listener.
Police across Massachusetts are cracking down on DUI with increased patrols and sobriety checkpoints. A DUI can cost you more than just your license. You may lose your job and even your freedom. I'm Attorney John Seed, former Boston DUI prosecutor specializing in drunk driving defense. I can help you get your life back after a DUI arrest. My trial experience on both sides of the law is the critical factor in defending DUI cases. Don't let a DUI destroy your life. Call me, John Seed, today, 617-254-8000, or visit johnseedlaw.com.
I'm Evan Falchuk, and I'm the United Independent Party candidate for governor of Massachusetts. Like most voters, I know lawmakers aren't spending our tax dollars wisely. They just came up with $1 billion to expand the Boston Convention Center, but they tell us they can't fund what we need, like healthcare, education, and job training. This just doesn't make sense. Things won't change until we vote to make a change. I'm Evan Falchuk, and I believe we can start to fix things. To learn how, please visit Falchuk2014.org.
Paid for by Falchuk for Governor.
WEMF. Radio Now.
There we are. That is Evan Falchuk for Governor ad that we just decided to run.
Yeah.
Yeah, we're running him.
We like him. He's running. We're running it for him. We're the Young Jerks.
At WEMF Radio every Saturday at 6 p.m. And we're going to talk about the campaign of Evan Falchuk.
For sure, for sure. Lots going on with Evan's campaign. You know, he's catching a lot of momentum right now. He's moving up in the polls.
We can feel
he's
it
being
on Facebook.
Kicked out of debates because he's so badass.
We can tell he's doing good. You know why? Because we're doing good.
Yeah.
You know, we feel the buzz on our show when certain issues get big and we're covering them. And he's one. Like, the rest of the mainstream media pretending, oh, this guy's nothing, he's not polling. They're a bunch of liars and jokers, because you know what? You're covering them, and why are you covering them? You're trying to put them down, but then you cover them again. Why? Because he's getting the eyeballs. He's getting the clicks. We're getting the clicks. We're getting... what has our social media been doing the last few
blowing
weeks?
Up.
Yeah, Evan Falchuk and this medical marijuana thing, both of those combined.
Yeah.
It's like the market basket thing. There were certain weeks there where we were booming. We could feel it. You can feel it on the show, and that's what's happening right now for Evan Falchuk. Let's talk about New England Cable News and the Worcester Telegram and Gazette. They kicked him out of this debate.
The best was when what's his name? Brody? Broward?
Well, that's what we're getting to. Let me get to that. You're jumping the gun.
I'm getting excited.
So this week, you know, kicked out of the New England Cable News debate. And people are upset on Facebook. People are upset on Twitter. We're hitting them up, I was hitting up Browdy all week. I was telling him, you know what, dude, I ain't going to listen to. He's like, Browdy, you had some other people coming up, like Ed Markey or something, a debate. And I posted right to him. I said, you know what, Jimmy, I ain't listening to New England Cable News. I ain't listening to your debate if you don't have Evan Falchuk on. People started posting these things, liking it, responding, going after the Telegram Gazette, going after New England Cable News. And Evan started talking about it.
Yep.
Evan went on New England Cable News with Jim Browdy.
It's true.
And you watched this, Frankie.
I did.
And this is the perfect example of what I'm talking about. They pretended like, oh, you don't have enough support or popularity to get on New England Cable News to have this debate with Martha Coakley and Charlie Baker. Why? Because he did too well at the first debate. They invited him to the New England Cable News debate, and then they disinvite him. And now, because everyone's upset, what do they do, Frankie?
Oh, they bring him on the show, Jim Browdy.
Yeah.
I don't know. The guy should spell his name phonetically. But at any rate, I digress.
Who's usually all right? Usually he's cool, right? Usually Jennings are cool guys.
I used to listen to the radio WTKK, show when it was on 96.9 before,
Boston
whatever,
Talks.
When I used to drive around.
Now he's on GBH with Marjorie. He's still doing the show with Marjorie. You know? I like his show. It's not a bad show.
No, the show's fine, but like the attitude, but the attitude that he took towards Falchuk was super combative, and where like he was defending his dad on the playground or something.
Yeah, he was trying to pin him. I'm gonna get you because you're not consistent. Like it was like basically trying to play this game, and it was obvious what the game was, and especially towards the end when Evan Falchuk does what he does very well. He stayed calm, he stayed collective, but he went on the offensive. He said, hey, what are you talking about? You guys are excluding me from the debates. Yeah. This is what's actually happening.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
This is a real deal, Jimmy. And Jimmy couldn't handle it. He got upset. He didn't look good in that.
No, no, no. And you could see it. You know, you could totally see that he was trying to come from a standpoint of, like, making him look bad and shrugging off the fact that they just decided not to have him on the debate. Like, oh, well, you're just not good enough. And it's like, dude, you never told me I had to be good in the first place.
Yeah,
you invited me. You want to come over to my house and hang out?
And then all of a sudden,
you're like, oh, no, you can't come over. I'm like, dude, why can't I come over to your house? Well, I don't know. You don't have a green shirt on. I don't know. You can't come over to my house. Like, I mean, that's essentially what they did.
Yeah, they did. And they said, yeah, you can't get the... Then she said, Evan followed up and said, what's the real reason? They said, oh, because you don't have 10% in the poll.
He's like, well,
and then
Jimmy, was that in the first place?
Jimmy Brown goes, Browdy, or whatever his name is, goes, from New England Cable News, the big night, you know, big show, all big guy. He goes, well, you're only at 1 or 2% of the polls, right? So, why... And then... Evan goes, well, that's not quite true. I've actually been moving up, and last poll was 5.2. And what Evan didn't even bring up is that the margin of error was like 4.4 or 4.5.
Yeah, yeah.
So if you add that together, that's round that up, that's 10%. That's 9.8. That's 10%, dude.
Yeah.
He just got 10%.
But then the dude goes immediately to just trying to belittle that and saying, oh, well, yeah, you know, let's say you get 2% or let's say you get 3%. Let's say the United Independent Party actually becomes a party.
You so can't really
you
win.
Know, like, you're not really. You don't.
You
like,
can't really win.
Yeah.
When Jim Browdy's saying that and New England Cable News is a monopoly. Come on. Come on. You're deciding the election. Who gave you the power to decide, Jimmy?
Well, just the whole entire debate process is ridiculous. Like, now we have a Springfield debate that's just going to be Charlie Baker.
Yeah, there's a story on Mass Live about that.
What's the name of that? Just Charlie Baker.
One candidate debate. Because Martha won't show up
for an hour.
Yeah.
She's like, oh, and not like, oh, well, maybe we should just invite Falchuk, or maybe we should invite, you know, McCormick, or maybe we should, you know, throw tomatoes at Lyle. I don't know. Like, maybe we should do something, like, and bring another candidate on. Nah, we'll just have Charlie Baker on. He'll talk for an hour. And,
solo debate.
You know, people can, you know, he can debate himself. What Falchuk actually said something funny.
They can set up a mirror.
Yeah.
He said, what did he say? He's like, he said that what's Charlie Baker, or I don't know if it was Falchuk or the Falchuk campaign, but they're like, what's Charlie Baker going to do? He's going to sit there and, you know, debate his fists or something like that? Or, like, one hand's going to debate, I don't know.
The other hand?
It was funny.
He's going to debate
like Will Ferrell skit.
His thumbs, like he was going to bait his thumbs. I don't know.
He's going to be like, excuse me, honey. What was that thing you
sweetheart.
Said? Sweetheart.
He'd be like,
excuse me, sweetheart.
And then he'd be like, you shouldn't talk to me like that.
Yeah.
That's misogynist. You'd be like, no, I mean, I wasn't really trying to say that. He'll
be
just
like a Monty Python.
All of a sudden turn into Two-Face.
Yeah.
You know, he'd just pour some acid on his face.
I don't know.
And he'd be like, I don't know.
I mean, this is ridiculous.
This is
absolutely
ridiculous. It's about as ridiculous as we're talking about it right now.
That's exactly what I'm saying. It's ridiculous. Like, I don't want to hear a debate unless Evan's involved in it for governor. It's
you're not an adult. You can't make choices. Yeah. We're going to make them for you because super PACs give us money. You see? Yeah. And when those super PACs threaten not to give us money, well, geez, I don't know if we can still have you on the show.
Yeah.
You know,
that's exactly
old
what's happening.
Ready for you know, Martha was going to build us a new deck this year. Don't know if we can let John. Sorry.
Democrats and Republicans, they're doing that. They do not want this third party voice in there that's strong, that has money behind them, that's saying the right things. We are almost out of time, and we got to thank everyone for being on the show. Thank you, Dave Crespo, behind the board.
Thanks, Dave.
Thank you, Dave.
Thanks.
Thank you, guys.
Thank you, Healthy Hetty, for coming in.
Thank you for having us.
Be always Holly. Being awesome.
Awesome.
Holly and Greg.
Thank you.
Yeah, yeah.
And thank you, Kyle Mann, doing our pictures over here, photos. He didn't even get to weigh in. He was supposed to speak up on the air today. We had too much to do. And next week, we got to talk about next week.
Yeah, so we've got some pretty cool, we've got a little like round table.
A huge round table. We didn't even get to it. Who are we going to have on real quick? I know a couple people from Evan Falchuk's campaign. We're going to have Trinidad here.
Yep.
Trinidad Kearney, people know her from Twitter. She's one of the big campaign people. We're going to have another gentleman from Evan Falchuk's campaign that you'll see in a video that Evan just posted. They're talking about the coffee and beef jerky, Evan and him. He's going to be in here next week.
Yeah, and who else? We've got Dan Fishman coming in also.
Libertarian
candidate. And we're also going to be having Evan Kenney.
Definitely. He's confirmed.
Yep.
Evan Republican Kenney, all-stars coming in.
Republican all-star Evan Kenney will be here. And
Pirate Party.
Two
members running for U.S. state rep.
We've got Noah Lani. Yeah. Will be gracing us with their presence. And go Joe Gertin as well.
And maybe a Democrat.
We're going to have a whole... Basically, there's going to be a whole gang of people here. And we're going to talk about the elections.
Jerks,
we're going to be talking about what it's like to run for third parties. We're going to have a little third-party summit. And then we're going to throw some old hacks from the Republican and the Democratic Party in there, too.
Well,
some of them are young hacks. I don't know. At any rate, maybe they're not hacks.
It's going to be a big political debate next week about the governor's race.
It's going to be good. It's going to be a political orgy. Exactly. It's going to be just a schizophrenic hodgepodge. It's going to be a cuddle puddle, only there's going to be politics. All right. At any rate, it's going to be great.
We're going to beat you with joints.
It's going to be a chair fight.
We will beat people with joints next week. Politicians. Young politicians.
Young politicians will be beat with joints, and it will be awesome. And it will be on YouTube for your viewing pleasure.